Hello and welcome back to the finals of the World Championship in Through the Ages. After 8 games finished, I'm now 29 points in the first position, and I'm definitely happy about how the standings are looking at the moment. The last game that we saw was a 2-player game against Zwin that I was able to win, and now we are going to take a look at a 3-player game again, and it will be a 3-player game against Matapeshwar and Cengizsip. And now without further ado, we are going to take a look at the game. In this game, I'm in the first position, and first of all, we can take a look at the Leaders and Wonders. And we can see that there is definitely some culture synergy in there, with Marlene Dietrich, Fleming, the Chaplain being in there, also Gandhi, the Internet, but there's no Hollywood. Also in H2 we have Bach, Shakespeare and Gaudi, so definitely some culture synergy there, but there is also Bill Gates, apart from him, not any lab leaders, though. There's also Einstein. And then we have Mandela, there is no spaceflight, but there is the Red Cross, there is the Manhattan Project. In H2 we have the Ocean Liner Service, but no Maria, we have the Suez Canal, but no James Cook. We have one military action leader with Robespierre, James Watt is there together with the railroad, there are the two science leaders with Nobel and Newton. In H1 there's one military action leader with, with Chin of Arc and Jan Žižka, there's also Nostradamus for the strength. We have Michelangelo together with St. Peter's Basilica, there's also Columbus and Isabella, who maybe could work nicely in a colonization game with the Suez Canal. The Silk Road is there, the Great Wall and Nemichi Castle, so the two strength wonders and also the two happy face solution wonders. I'm in first position and I think here I should pick one of those two leaders. I don't think there is anything to gain here with not committing. I think Boudica is a leader that I would place a little bit above both those two leaders that are available for me now, but I also thought she might very likely be taken away. There could of course Confucius could come out, but he won't be available for one civil action. And so I will take one of those leaders. Both of those leaders I like a bit more when playing in a later seat, because both of them profit from getting H1 cards early, and in the third seat H1 cards will be available earlier for cheaper. And so, generally I evaluate them relatively similarly, but Ashoka has also the advantage when playing in a later position that you often can take him together with a yellow card, and that just makes it even easier to activate this bonus. So he has another downside when I take him now without being able to get a yellow card, and with that I think Aristotle is maybe just a little bit better, and the science of him will hopefully be quite useful. Matapeshwar will then go for Ashoka, and he can take a yellow card together with him, so that definitely makes him quite a bit stronger. And Cengizsip will then go for Boudica and also the Frugality, so all the players took a leader for now. And then it is my turn. I will build a mine, and this turn I wasn't totally certain what I want to go for. There are two wonders available for one civil action. Both of them are maybe not too strong, but can definitely be fine. There's an engineering genius in the row. And I thought that for the decision whether I maybe want to go red or would like to go for Hanging Gardens or Acropolis, I thought maybe the Acropolis I like a little bit more. Being able to go for the monarchy cheaper could synergize with Aristotle, and then grabbing the monarchy would also score me one science, so that could be a little bit of a synergy. And also, as we saw, there are some culture leaders in there, so maybe the Acropolis could be a nice wonder depending on how the game goes. The Hanging Gardens of course can also be useful with the happy faces, also in culture games, but I thought the Acropolis I like a little bit more. However, if I take the Acropolis, and if Matapeshwar should go for the wonder for one civil action, the Rome Roads, then the pyramids would fall down to one civil action, while if I go for the Hanging Gardens, then the pyramids would stay on two civil actions. Don't know if it's that important, because I thought Matapeshwar might be willing to pay an additional civil action for the pyramids, because it's the more fitting wonder together with Ashoka. But that was one thing that I was thinking about. And I just didn't like the thought too much that maybe Cengizsip will get the engineering genius and a strong wonder, either the Rome Roads or the pyramids available for one civil action. So there's also the Rome Roads of course available, but for that I don't want to pay an additional civil action. I think taking the pyramids for three could at least be considered, but at the end I think it's too expensive. But with Aristotle it's a nice combination, so, and it's not a big deal to not elect Aristotle immediately, so it could be considered, but I think With having a wand available for one civil action, it would be too expensive. And at the end, I went for the Acropolis, just because I thought it is better for me. I thought Matapeshir might likely go for the pyramids anyway instead of the Rome roads, and I was hoping that maybe he could even go for either pyramids and engineering genius or Rome roads and engineering genius to take a strong combination away from Cengizip. Alternatively, I could also go for the engineering genius myself. As said, delaying Aristotle is not that bad. On the other hand, if there's an interesting technology in the row, it could be maybe a bit bad not being able to grab it easily with already electing Aristotle and maybe getting my second lab going already. So I thought just for myself, grabbing the engineering genius is not that great. I had some hope that maybe Matapeshir would take it, and for him it could still be fine, but not as strong as it might be when Cengizip gets it maybe for one civil action together with a wonder. And at the end I just then increased my population and went for Aristotle. Then I draw the naval trade agreements in the raiders. Matapeshir will indeed take the engineering genius, and he also takes the pyramid, so he takes two cards for two civil actions each. It is somewhat expensive, but the pyramid is also a nice wonder together with Ashoka. He can maybe even finish it at the next turn, elect Ashoka, take a card, maybe get a production going like this with having the urban growth also still in hand. So it is somewhat expensive. Maybe if he only looks at his own gains, it could be better to take pyramids and build a mine, increase his population, but there's also the thing that he denies now the engineering genius from the Rome roads, and the engineering genius at least allows him to potentially maybe finish the pyramids already the next turn, which could be nice together with Ashoka. So it's also still a very fine move for himself, and he also denies Cengizip the engineering genius for one. So I was, I think it's a fine move, but I also was not unhappy about it, because it is also somewhat costly, and Cengizip doesn't get the engineering genius for one. Cengizip then goes for Boudica, will take the Rome roads, builds a mine and increases his population, so just normal stuff. At my turn, I just, because I didn't really want to commit to the raiders yet, offered a naval trade agreement, didn't really expect that it will be accepted. Because it will take a while until the deck will flip and until the plus one colonization force can actually do something for Cengizip, but he accepts it, and I gain two additional blue tokens. There's a Suez Canal in there, so maybe this pack can at some point do something for Cengizip. Maybe he has even drawn a strong colony already. Then this turn I definitely want to go for the alchemy. It's just very nice to get something that I can invest my resources into early. And at the next turn I will be able to go for the alchemy, and I also wanted to take the drama here that has two nice benefits. First of all, it scores me a science with Aristotle, and I get it for one civil action, and it could in this game maybe not be a bad technology. There's Bach, there's Marlene, there are some other culture leaders, so a technology that has some potential. I gain a science with Aristotle, and gaining the science with Aristotle will also allow me to use my last civil action in a nice way, because now I actually have enough to develop the alchemy, and at the next turn I can then just build an alchemy directly. If I wouldn't have the science from the drama, then I either would have to take an HA yellow card, or I increase my population, go into consumption, or I build the lab now to get the science production, but I can't build a lab directly then and save a civil action with that. So I think being able to develop the alchemy already this turn is just very nice, and Aristotle has now already scored me two science, so I was quite happy about the start so far. I draw two cards. The medieval army tactic is of course nice to have, so now if I should get a chance to get knights, then maybe I should probably take them. Matapeshir will not finish the pyramids this turn. Instead he goes for the second lab, gets a little bit of science production going, and then it is even possible for him to already activate the full Ashoka bonus, which could also cause him a bit of corruption issues, but still it should be very nice, because the masonry is a card that he can use nicely, the swordsman, the military tech, getting that for one civil action is not bad, and he also activates the Ashoka bonus, so that should be a strong turn. Cengizip goes for the Code of Laws. He can potentially develop it at the next turn if he takes the science from Boudica, and he also maybe denies it from me. I think it's also strong enough for it himself, but giving it to Aristotle, who will be able to go for the alchemy now, would maybe also something that he doesn't really like. I made the decision to seed the raiders here. As you can see, knights are on the row. I have the medieval army tactic. I will gain one additional strength from the Acropolis, so I thought I might have the chance to maybe have an easy way to get some strength going, and so I decided to start pushing the deck now with seeding the raiders. The development of warfare is revealed. And I have to think if I even want to take the warrior, because taking it takes the possibility away to build an alchemy directly this turn. Also, if I at some point maybe should get Yanshishka, then I maybe don't really need the warrior. But I thought it should still be quite likely that it will be somewhat useful for me, this warrior. And I can't build an alchemy, that will sadly cost me one science, but I can still upgrade my lab to the alchemy, getting out of corruption like this. Also with taking the warrior, it makes it that Cengizip will now only be able to use the two additional military resources with Boudica, which can also be fine. He maybe wants to build some strength at some point anyway, but especially with maybe a science allowing him to go for the Code of Laws, it could be a bit annoying, and so that is also a benefit, because Matabishir doesn't have a free population, so he won't be able to take the free warrior. The same is true for Cengizip, and as at the end I was willing to take the warrior, my last civil action, I will increase my population. I didn't want to take another card. I thought those cards are maybe not that interesting anyway. And at the next turn now I can increase my population, build an alchemy directly, then maybe at the next turn then I have still two civil actions. And I thought maybe it's I can use the civil action that I gain with increasing my population now better at the next turn than I could use it now. I draw the cultural influence and the new deposits. Matabishir will go for the masonry, will also reveal the fighting band tactic, finishes the pyramids, gets out of corruption with increasing his population, and then he can also take the cartography. There is a Suez Canal in there, and he also activates the Ashoka bonus, so those two reasons might already be enough to take the cartography. Maybe he has even drawn already a strong colony. Cengizip has now to use the two additional resources for the military, for that he will increase his population two times, that allows him to put a work into the warriors. It's now two strength, and then to get out of corruption he builds a step of the Rome roads and takes the breakthrough for one civil action. He also reveals the legion tactic. At my turn I seed again, this time the cultural influence. I don't know which player will get iron, so I don't want to seed the new deposits yet, I don't want to seed a colony at the moment, so I just seeded a cultural influence. I at least have one additional cultural production that I will get from the Acropolis. It's just a neutral event, and I wanted to move the deck forward so that my raiders or potential other events that I maybe will be able to seed at the following turns are maybe a bit revealed earlier. Then the development of agriculture is revealed. I will increase my population, I will this turn build the second lab, going up to 4 science production, so that's definitely not bad. And then this turn I think there are indeed more interesting cards available than at the last turn. I can take the Engineering Genius for one civil action, can use that very nicely on the Acropolis. And then I have another civil action left, and I also thought that Columbus is quite a nice card for me here. There are of course some other leaders that I could go for, there are even John of Arc and Yanshishka coming down the road at the moment, but I really don't know if those will still be available for me at the next turn. And Yanshishka is maybe not that ideal with having the second warrior now, because I can go for 2 knights, but then I get 2 tactics anyway, so I would need to go for 3 knights until Yanshishka really does give me some additional strength. And John of Arc, for her I don't have the free religion yet, so both of those are of course fine leaders, but I don't think those would be too strong for me in the situation. Well, with Columbus I can just keep Aristotle for a little while longer, he can maybe score me a bit more science, and then he is just a very strong transitional leader. There is the Suez Canal in there, and I have the wealthy territory at least already in hand, have the chance to maybe draw a better colony, but with me having started into alchemy production, into science production, and with still being on bronze mines, the wealthy territory I think is actually quite a fine colony to get with Columbus, and can maybe help me to boost my economy. So I keep it in hand together with the medieval army tactic. I even draw 2 more tactics. I probably don't need those, but maybe it could mean that my opponents won't have them available. Matabishir builds a warrior, goes up to 3 strength. With that he also makes it a Cengizip. Again, will need to take the additional resource from Boudica. Then he takes the rich land, the alchemy. Sadly, that means that a Code of Laws will be discarded for me, which could still be a very strong card for me to get. And then he increases his population a bunch of times to get out of corruption. Then Cengizip will increase his population, can build another warrior, has now the legion tactic fulfilled, will develop the Code of Laws and just finishes the Rome roads. Gets out of corruption, however, he misses out on some interesting leaders, but there are still some other leaders in the deck, so he maybe wants to wait for those and wasn't willing to miss out on any of the stuff, using the resources, finishing the Rome roads in order to grab one of those leaders. Now it's my turn. I have a full hand. I kind of want to keep Aristotle for one turn longer, and I also want to even score science with him this turn, so I don't want to elect Columbus to make space in my hand. Instead, I will make space in my hand with using the engineering genius. And then I take the iron, and I just develop the iron. At the next turn, I can maybe start with upgrading my production. I could have thought about electing Columbus, because with already getting the wealthy territory at the next turn, I can maybe go for more upgrades. But there's also the chance to maybe score more science with Aristotle. Two monarchies are coming down the row, also a bunch of other technologies. So I thought I am willing to wait with electing Columbus. The age won't end before my next turn. And so I keep Aristotle, and at the next turn can maybe start with upgrading to iron. I thought having a bit of iron production could still be nice, even though it's a little bit late. Maybe I can boost my production with the wealthy territory, or even if not, it could still be nice. There are some interesting H2 wonders. The Suez Canal could be interesting with me getting a free colony with Columbus already. This ocean liner service is interesting. Railroad potentially as well. So finishing those wonders could just be a bit easier with having iron production going. I then draw the foray and the kidnap. Marta Pescher will go for the alchemy, can go for two quite cheap upgrades with having the masonry, has also still an urban growth A in hand that he can use now, goes up to 4 science production, takes the iron, he has just enough science to develop that at the next turn with the rich land, he can even go for 2 upgrades if he wants to, and he also takes Janšiška, has even 5 colors in hand. Sadly, there's no additional bonus for that. That could of course be a nice feature, but and the next turn he can and go maybe for some nice iron production. Cengizip takes the monarchy and the St. Peter's Basilica, interestingly. He has a bunch of resources that he needs to invest somehow, and both me and Marta Pescher have now taken iron and alchemy. That, of course, leaves him taken with that. Of course, there are some strong cards taken away where you can maybe invest your resources nicely, and he wants to solve this now with going for the St. Peter's Basilica, getting a happy face solution basically for the rest of the game. The next turn he can maybe even develop the monarchy, finish the wonder to get out of corruption, and this turn he can get out of corruption with everything increasing his population. This turn I will seed the foray. The raiders are in there anyway. I still have the medieval army tactic in hand, so I thought I can maybe still play some strength events and was hoping that I will manage to be one of the two strongest. The development of settlement is revealed, so even more population available. I certainly want to go for the monarchy this turn. I can get that going for only 2 science cheaper, so not that much of a discount, but still it's quite nice. Then I can develop it. And then I still have 3 civil actions left. To get out of, I definitely want to go for 1 iron upgrade, and I have 2 civil actions left, and I am already out of corruption, and there are still some cards in the row that I could potentially take. And the question is, do I want to take 2 of them, or do I want to take 1 of them and then increase my population? So, I think all of those technologies that are on the row are somewhat useful for me. But also not too strong, but because of having Aristotle, it definitely has to be considered to take them. And at the end, I first of all took the Breton Circuses. Sadly, there's not a lot of synergy for arenas in the game, no Pierre, no Darwin, but it scores me no science with Aristotle, and there has been no development of religion revealed yet. And also, I have seeded some strength events, and who knows, maybe the Breton Circuses, at least with how it is looking at the moment, could allow me to have an additional 3 population available, and if there is a bit of a strength race ongoing, which could potentially be the case, then it could turn out to be useful to have the Breton Circuses in hand. And then I, at the end, also made the decision to take the irrigation. First I thought I maybe don't really need the irrigation, and maybe I also won't need it, but it could be that it is at least fine to have it in hand, because I will now start with, first of all, going for some iron production, and I will elect Columbus. And Cengizip has now just taken the St. Peter's Basilica. That means that he can't easily grab an H2 wonder, meaning that I maybe have a little bit of an edge against Marta Pescher in maybe getting a chance to take one of those strong H2 wonders, mainly Suez Canal or Ocean Liner Service. And if I should get the Ocean Liner Service, then the irrigation is a nice way to get out of famine. If I at some point should get the Suez Canal, maybe even with the Yellow Token Colony, then that could potentially also be nice to have the irrigation together with some additional additional yellow tokens, and if I don't have anything better to invest into, it could also still be fine to maybe have the irrigation, maybe if the selective breedings are taken away early or something like this, or maybe I won't need it at the end, but there are some chances that it will be useful, and it scores me another science with Aristotle, and with that at the end I was willing to take it, but alternatively I could also increase my population and would be totally fine with it. At the end I scored now 7 signs with Aristotle, which I think is definitely a fine amount, and I will get a nice transitional leader now, so I think so far I have gotten a nice value out of my leaders. I will also reveal the medieval army tactic already this turn, so that I will get more H2 draws in. And I was happy to see that I actually get 2 more colonies that I can potentially use with Columbus. So at my next turn I can now even choose what colony I want to colonize with Columbus, or if I maybe even want to wait with potentially drawing an H2 colony. Matabeshir seats and the development of science is revealed. He goes for the iron, will build an iron directly. He, I think, had delayed building this third mine, which was possible or which was fine with having Ashoka, but now he will go for a third mine, also takes the breakthrough and the theology, doesn't elect Jan Šuška yet. Cengiz succeeds, and the development of religion is revealed, with that having the arenas or the panegyrics in hand is maybe not that ideal, but it could still be fine. Cengiz will develop the monarchy, but he won't finish the St. Peter's Basilica, because with that he wouldn't have enough civil actions to take the strategy, and he maybe doesn't want to give the strategy to me, which I think is definitely a good decision, because I have easily enough science to invest into it, and together with the medieval armies, who knows, maybe stuff could even get a bit dangerous for Cengiz, and like this he can go for it at some point and denies it from me, so I think that makes some sense, and at least he can still get out of corruption with building 2 stages of the St. Peter's Basilica. Nostradamus will now be discarded, but maybe at the next turn he can go for Michelangelo and maybe start a bit of culture production. Which could potentially be bad, because there's actually the cultural influence in there that I seeded. Then at my turn, there I have to indeed make the decision what colony I want to go for, or if I maybe want to wait with going for a colony. I think if I want to colonize now, the main contenders are either inhabited territory or wealthy territory, because the science from the developed territory is at the moment not that much needed, so I think the benefits from the inhabited territory should be better than those from the developed territory, but the benefits from the wealthy territory are quite a bit different, so I think between those two it has to be decided, and normally the inhabited territory is probably the stronger colony to colonize with Columbus. But I was playing out some different turns with colonizing those different colonies, and at the end I just liked the turn more where I go for the wealthy territory now, because I actually think those resources, getting those now, is quite useful. Of course, the yellow tokens will also be useful, will maybe make the irrigation worthwhile investment potentially, now that I have taken it anyway, it could help me with my population, so maybe I could regret it at some point. But if I go for the inhabited territory, I have 5 resources available, and with having seeded those strength events, especially the foray, I kinda want to get stronger. I want to build a knight, and then with going for the inhabited territory, I have only 2 resources, I can't go for any more iron upgrades. I then have to take some cards. I mean, the rich land could be fine, so I could take some fine cards, but also not that great cards, and my iron production would be quite a bit delayed, and at the end I just liked the turn with the wealthy territory more, and with that I at the end colonized it, and also didn't want to wait for an H2 colony, because I will invest at least 1 military action this turn, and the resources are just useful now, because that allows me the 6 additional resources to go for a knight, while also going for 2 upgrades, giving my economy a nice boost, and then I can go for a knight. Not having the population could potentially be bad, because in case my opponents will fight over the strength, then I don't have an easy way maybe to get another knight going. Potentially I could destroy the religion, go for Britain Circuses and go for a knight, but that's maybe also, that's of course not ideal. But at the moment Cengiz can only build a warrior. He has not enough science to go for the strategy immediately. Matabeshir has some ways to get stronger, but maybe also Radar wants to invest into some productions. I was hoping that my opponents at the moment won't go for a lot more strength quickly. And with that, I was willing to go for this wealthy territory, because it just boosts my economy. Now I have all of my iron mines fully upgraded, if there is something like Suez Canal or Ocean Liner Service, or even Railroad in the row at the next turn. Or even the Kremlin could be nice with being at the moment in monarchy and not having the most civil and military actions, especially when thinking about the long term, about the long game. Then I think it can just make a very big difference with having already upgraded all of those mines, and instead of only having upgraded one and still needing to upgrade. So at the end, because of that, I was willing to go for the wealthy territory, actually. And then with my last civil action, I will just take the reserves. I don't think I need any of those cards in a row. I mean, Swordsman could potentially be nice in case I miss out on the Rifleman. So that card definitely could be considered instead of the reserves, but at the end, I just thought I rather want to wait for potentially Rifleman, and I have already a lot of technologies in hand, so I have also maybe be a little bit careful. All of those technologies are somewhat technologies that I'm not sure if I even want to use those, just technologies that maybe open up some more options, and the Swordsman would be another one of another type of this technology. Of those technologies, so instead I rather wanted to have a card that I can use for certain, and that is the reserves. I draw two cards, the Wealthy Territory 2 and also a Colonization card. Montabashir seeds and gets somewhat punished for it. He is the weakest and will open the fray, but we can also see at his turn that he won't get stronger anyway, so if he had a nice card to seed, or maybe, I don't know if he, I think he has seeded one of those cards, if that is maybe something that could be useful for him this turn, then I think it definitely makes a lot of sense to seed. He then goes for the cartography, maybe expects a colony to come, either from the, either he seeded one himself, or maybe thinks that I or Cengizib have seeded one, especially Cengizib, who had the naval trade agreement pact with me quite a while, could of course potentially if seeded one, he takes the rich land at journalism. Thanks to the masonry, he has even just enough resource to build a journalism at the next turn, if he wants to. Cengizib skips the H1 leader, doesn't go for Michelangelo for some cultural reduction, instead rather wants to go for some economy, and James Watt is certainly quite helpful for him, because with him, he has enough science to go for the coal immediately, gets a very early coal going, goes for an upgrade, builds a warrior to get out of corruption, but also to make sure that he isn't the weakest after his turn, and with James Watt he will get those upgrades going quite quickly and also quite cheaply, so that, yeah, it's definitely a strong James Watt, can maybe also go for selective breeding at some point, potentially, so, yeah, definitely not bad for him. This turn I won't seed. I thought about seeding a colony, because there is the navigation available for me, and I thought maybe I can still go for a bit of a colonization game. There is the Suez Canal in there, I have already one colony. But both of my opponents at the moment have also a colonization force, of course I can maybe cancel this pact at some point. And also there are actually quite a lot of strong cards available for me, and it isn't that easy to get a navigation. I would have to miss out on another strong card, because as you can see there's the Justice System. There are two copies of Rifleman, with not having to take the Swordsman, I need to take those Rifleman now. Or at least it would be very risky to not take them, so I think it's a must take basically. And then it's really not that easy to get navigation, or it's actually impossible to get navigation and revolutionary idea. So if you want to get navigation, I would have to miss out on the revolutionary idea. I think that would be quite a strong card to get from Montabashir, who still needs an H2 government form. It's also a useful card for myself, so instead of starting to seed even more colonies, and I just skip my politics phase and skip the navigation at the end, I will go for the justice system. I think that's a nice addition to my civilization, making it that I'm now at 6 civil actions. And then, as said, I really want to have the Rifleman, I want to have the revolutionary idea, and then with my last civil action, I just increased my population, because it's really not looking like any of my opponents has seeded the rebellion, so I, and the chances may be rather that there are rats seeded, so I think increasing my population just makes me safe from potential rats, and the rebellion is very likely not in there. And also, of course, I only could increase my population thanks to the foray. I took 3 food from that, and with that I have another population now. I draw a Volvo territory, also the arms industry and the scientific corporation. Montabashir will seed and opens the barbarians. I have actually the most culture, but I'm also the strongest, so I don't get hit by that. Montabashir will then go for Newton, goes for the journalism, builds one, is now at 8 science production, so he gets a nice boost to his economy now with going for Newton, also gets a bit of culture production going, and as soon as he gets an H2 government form with this nice science production, he certainly could maybe get a nice position. He also takes the Rifleman and the urban growth. Cengizib will take the selective breeding, he definitely wants to have that with having James Watt, And then he goes one more upgrade to his mines, finishes the St. Peter's Basilica, takes the breakthrough, and also takes the cavalryman. And now at my next turn, I think I really have to make a decision here that is somewhat maybe deciding in which direction I want to move the game, or in which direction the game will be going for me. One thing that I considered was to go for a war over territory against Mata Peshawar, and then I can just take and finish the Transcontinental Railroad, going up to 12 strength, increasing my resource production. And Mata Peshawar doesn't have a lot of resources saved up. He also at the moment doesn't have any free population. He can go for Rifleman, but if he wants to build one, he needs to destroy something. He doesn't have enough resource to go for two upgrades. So it's really not that easy for him to not lose two yellow tokens. He can't really make it that he doesn't lose any yellow token, that he wins the war. And it was also not easy for him to not lose two yellow tokens. Could potentially do it with going for team sports with the urban growth and then for swordsmen instead of riflemen, but that would be really not ideal. So I considered it. I think it would be somewhat annoying for Mata Peshawar. I would very likely get two additional yellow tokens. I would at least increase my resource production going up to 8, so that definitely has some benefits. I also considered just maybe going for the Suez Canal, but I can't finish that immediately. I have only one colony. The colonies I have in hand, Wealthy Territory 2 and Inhabited 1, are somewhat fine, but maybe also don't justify to go for the Suez Canal for that expensive. But I can definitely still think about it. But the railroad play I definitely considered more, but at the end I thought there is just a play that is probably the best here, and that is to go for Bach. I need a new leader anyway. I have the drama in hand, I have the Acropolis, and what is on top of that, there is also the cultural influence in the deck, and if I set up some dramas now, I could really get quite a big culture boost. And at the end, that was just a turn that looked the best for me. Sadly, Mata Peshawar like this won't get disrupted. There is definitely some danger to it. Maybe it will allow him to use this big science production to set up quite a strong economy. But still, at the end, I just thought this Bach play looks a lot better for myself. And we can maybe now take a look at it and then compare it again to the railroad play. I first of all have to make space in my hand. I will play the reserves for food. I could also play it for resource, because at the moment it's not clear how nice those food will be. But if I go for Bach and dramas, then every population is just as quite nice. Either I get the selective breeding going, then the food will be useful at some point, or I maybe could also still hope to get the ocean liner service, because I won't take a wonder this turn, and then that could at least be nice to maybe avoid famine at some point. So I thought it should be nice to play it for food. Then I go for Bach, and then I just build two dramas. Don't think there are any cards that I really have to take or something, so I can just build those two dramas going up to 10 culture reduction, and with the cultural influence that could really make it that I get quite a big culture boost going. And at the end, I just thought that this may be the best. I get this culture production going very cheaply. And if I now just focus on still keeping a somewhat balanced civilization, making sure that I can do my best to defend myself, then with having this culture production on top, I thought I might be in a strong position. The railroad, of course, would increase my resource production. I would economically be in a better situation. I would disrupt Mata Peshawar, but at the end, I would be in a situation where I have 6 civil actions with the monarchy, where I don't have the most free population, where I don't have strategy, I'm on 3 military actions, so it could be fine, but I still thought Mata Peshawar with his big science production, if he gets an H2 government form, could get quite a big boost. Chengisip will get some very cheap upgrades with James Watt. The next turn can potentially even go for his last coal upgrade and for 2 selective breedings upgrades. So I thought I just... in an economical battle, maybe I could still do fine with the railroad, but I might not have really a big advantage. And like this, at least I have something going that my opponents don't have going, a lot of culture reduction, and my economy is still somewhat decent. So at the end, I thought that should be quite strong. I even thought about going for an even greedier move, because at the beginning of the turn, I had to make space in my hand with going for the reserves. But I actually considered, instead of playing the reserves, to develop the drama without having Bach. Then going for Bach, then I would have 1 free civil action at the end, and could even upgrade this religion to a drama, giving me 2 more culture production, and if the cultural influence is revealed before the next turn, even another 2 culture production. But I don't have the most science production. It's fine, but not that big. I have the revolutionary idea, but I still thought, especially if I maybe want to go for an H3 government form at some point with the Acropolis, I could still use every bit of science, and it might at the end just be a bit too greedy to not get a 2 science discount from Bach. It might still be worth more to the science than the culture, and so I didn't go for this very greedy turn. I also thought about only going for Bach and then maybe taking the Suez Canal, but I think, as said, with only having one colony and those colonies that I have in hand, the Suez Canal is not as strong, and with not taking the Suez Canal, I also leave myself open for a potential ocean liner service. I have actually enough resources and civil actions to potentially take and finish the Suez Canal, Canal at the next turn, but sadly that will be very unlikely to happen, because if Mata Bashir takes those 2 yellow cards, which is quite likely, then the Suez Canal will be discarded before my next turn. I draw another pact and also two event cards. Mata Bashir will go for his last mine upgrade, goes for the team spots, develops the team spots, makes sure that he doesn't have any happy face issues. Also, I think there's no Pierre in there, but still, there should be a better happy face solution in the theology. And he still leaves him with enough science to go for a government form at the next turn. The Suez Canal will indeed sadly be discarded, Genghis succeeds, and the raiders are revealed, so I also was managed to not get hit by that event, so the strength events worked out quite nicely so far. Genghis will go for one more coal upgrade, develops the selective breeding, goes for 2 upgrades there, so he really sets himself up for a strong economy, and then with his last 2 civil actions he just takes the cannons. He missed out on the riflemen, so having the cannons could be quite important. And now there could be a fight over the last copy of cannons, because both I and Mata Bashir might really like to have this copy, especially because Mata Bashir actually missed out on the cavalryman, so the last copy of cannon could at the end be quite important. And also something to note is that Cengizip, when he developed the selective breeding, he actually didn't use the breakthrough that he had in hand. That of course could be a big indicator that there are some dark ages coming, because he now even removed the option from him, for example, to go for the strategy at the next turn. So that really just looks like there might be dark ages in there, and that is of course a useful information to have. I am the strongest I could potentially think about seeding. But at the end, I rather offered an international trade agreement to Mata Bashir, and I took resource production for myself. Of course, with Bach, food production is nice, but you can also see that the ocean liner service is in the row. I will take it this turn, and I will have the irrigation to fix my famine. So at the end, the resource production, I thought, is better for me. And while I could, of course, see it with being the strongest, with maybe also opening the cultural influence, I also thought that those events that I have in hand are maybe not that nice to see. The refugees, with going for Bach, I really don't want to put a strength event in there, and with going for the ocean liner service, the prosperity might just be more helpful for my opponents, especially with Cengizip having the Hessian St. Peter's Basilica and Mata Bashir already having team spots, so I just offered a pact. And then I will indeed go for the ocean liner service. The second copy of selective breeding is quite late, and I need a lot of population, so I was definitely happy that I have the chance to get the ocean liner service, even though it is of course not that cheap, but that I will be able to finish it at the next turn, and it will allow me to get a bunch of population, and it could just be very strong with Bach. Then I also want to develop the irrigation already this turn. First of all, as said, there could potentially be dark ages, and at least I spend a little bit of science now. And is the chance that the age might end before the next turn. Not that likely maybe, but definitely possible. And so I just wanted to make sure that I can develop this. And then I have one last civil action. I could consider taking one of those cards. All of them are fine yellow cards. Maybe all of them are also no yellow cards that I really need or that are really strong for me. But all of them could be fine. With potentially dark ages coming, I could of course also think about investing into another technology, for example into Rifleman. However, I think it could be quite important to just build a step here, because first of all, I don't know whether I will need a Rifleman. Maybe I didn't develop it now and then I draw the mobile artillery or something like this, so it is also a commitment to develop into this Rifleman, especially because I don't have the most science available. Of course, maybe it will won't really cost that much science if there are dark ages revealed before my next turn, but it's also not a given. Of course, for my last civil action, I could also consider upgrading this religion, getting a potentially even bigger cultural influence, and that was actually also something that I considered, but I think it's important to build a step here, because I want to finish the ocean liner service at my next turn. And if there are cannons available, I think I really want to take them, because I have now this very nice cultural production going, and I can even build two more dramas with the Acropolis, so I can really set up a big cultural production. And if I take the cannons, Matapesha has only riflemen available, no cavalrymen, no cannons, and Cengizep has no riflemen available. So both of them don't have an easy way if they don't have the right tactics, then especially to gain a lot of strength. And that could be beneficial for me. So if the cannons are on three civil actions at the next turn, I don't want to be in a position where I either have to take the cannons or finish the ocean liner service. I want to do both. I want to be able to do both. And with that, I think it's important to build a step instead of potentially developing the rifleman or upgrading his religion. Of course, that could give me more culture with the cultural influence, but maybe it is also not revealed before the next turn, and then I can still maybe increase my cultural production for that. I draw some cards. Sadly, I don't have a tactic yet. That, of course, could potentially be dangerous at some point. Matapesha plays the reserves for food. With that, he makes space in his hand, and now he can go for the constitutional monarchy with the strategy gone. He's not willing to go for the republic. That would also maybe remove some military options from him at some point, if he maybe gets an opportunity to get maybe some H3 military techs or maybe military theory, and then set up a potential war against my cultural production. Cengizep will go for the scientific method. He again develops it without using the breakthrough, so big indicate. He goes for an upgrade. That upgrade won't give him that much science if the Dark Ages should be revealed, but it still at least gives him one science, basically, if the Dark Ages are revealed. But instead of a second upgrade, or actually wouldn't have enough science to go as resource to go for a second upgrade, but what he can do is for four resources to build a third farm. So now three farms, three mines, and we'll get some decent science production. So he has definitely a strong economy, not the most civil and military actions, also not the most science produced yet, so developing all of those technologies is not that easy, and he won't easily be able to set up a lot of strength quickly, which could be beneficial for me. But he definitely is setting up quite a decent economy. And then he increases his population one time, takes the frugality. Also, as you can see, the cannons are available, so I will be able to get this technology, and with that can remove the option for Matapesha to go for an artillery unit, at least until the first copy of rockets is available. This turn I won't see it. First of all, I will actually increase my cultural production this turn, so the cultural influence will be better after my turn, and also the Dark Ages that might be in there will be better after my turn, because I will go for the architecture, and also the events that I have in hand, I also all didn't really like any of them, even though I'm the strongest, but I think at this point it's almost for certain with Cengizep two times not using the breakthrough, and this time even it removes him the possibility again to go for strategy, to go for any of those units. It's almost certain that the Dark Ages are in there, so there are no strength events in there, and so I will go for the architecture. Normally, without having the knowledge about the Dark Ages, I would not go for the architecture, rather save up some science to maybe go for an H3 government form, or to go for military theory, to be able to go for air forces, but with the Dark Ages in there, and with the cost of the architecture basically even just being reduced, or not completely reduced, or quite reduced by a bit, I was at the end willing to go for the architecture, as it will maybe also save me a bit of resource. I mean, not that much in the dramas, but who knows, maybe I will also go for some more expensive buildings, and I can basically take it for free. It doesn't cost me any civil actions, because I can use it immediately in the ocean liner service. We'll finish the ocean liner service. I want to have the cannons. And then I thought about just taking the patriotism. It could be a somewhat useful card with the additional military action and some additional resources. But at the end, with the cultural influence coming, I just couldn't resist and just built a third drama, giving me also my happy faces, which I don't really need immediately. I could also consider developing the Breton circuses. because I would spend even more science then. The organized religion is the last happy face solution from age 2, and Genghis passed the St. Peter's Basilica, but could still consider taking it away. So I could be without a happy face solution, but for now I have enough happy faces. There are Chaplin, there is Marlene Dietrich, there are 2 copies of Professional Sports, and with that I didn't want to invest into the bread and circuses, especially with no PR being there. And instead I built a drama, which potentially might score me 6th culture if the cultural influence is revealed before my next turn. And so that was my turn at the end. I was hoping that at the moment, with Matapeshir not having the military text, and with Genghis not having that much science and not that many military actions yet, both of them can't go for a lot of military quickly, and with that I thought I can be fine without the patriotism. Keep some events, the colonization cards. I sadly still don't have a tactic available, so that could at some point be a problem. Ravages of Time, I probably also don't want to seed into the deck quickly with having the Acropolis, which can still do a nice job with giving me a cheap H3 government form. Matapeshir seeds, and a cultural influence is revealed now, and I gain 8 culture against both of my opponents, so that definitely turned out to be quite a strong card now. When I seeded it, I just considered it to be a neutral event, but now that it is revealed at the beginning of H3, and with giving me 8 additional culture, it is basically like a very early impact, so definitely I was happy how that turned out for me. Matapeshir then will fix his population or his food production, will go for selective breeding for 2 upgrades, and also develops the rifleman for free. He of course also saw that Genghis didn't use the breakthrough and draw his conclusions, and with that he prepares for the Dark Ages as nicely as possible, place the reserves for resources, with that goes for an upgrade and makes sure that he is the strongest now. Also uses the 1 free military action that he has. Genghis offers me the promise of military protection, and of course the false strength could at some point be useful, but it is not useful really against Genghis, because if he attacks me the pact is cancelled anyway, and Matapeshir at least at this point is not looking that threatening for the military. He first needs the right technologies maybe to make something work, and so at the end I just didn't want to miss out on culture production for this pact and rejected it. The only fear that I had was that Genghis maybe offers it again at the next turn to Matapeshir and gives Matapeshir the 4 additional strength. That could potentially maybe be dangerous if Matapeshir gets the right cards quickly and sets up some military pressure, but so I thought about even accepting it and cancelling it, but I just thought that's maybe also not that likely that Genghis will offer it again to Matapeshir, so I at the end just rejected it. And Genghis offering the pact could also mean, which is maybe bad news for him, that he doesn't have a nice card in hand to seed, because if there are indeed Dark Ages, which should be very likely, then he probably would like to open those now, because he could only develop the organized religion this turn, otherwise he will save up some science, so it seems like he doesn't have a nice card to seed in hand, which is a bit unfortunate for him. He uses the frugality, gets 2 more population out, actually reveals the fortifications tactic, interestingly, maybe wants to keep some other cards in hand, potentially. I was relatively happy to see it, because I don't have any tactic. I have the cannons, so I can maybe just start with building some cannons, and if I don't get another tactic, then that's at least a tactic that I can work with now, so I was happy to see it. On the other hand, of course, it also means that Genghis has a tactic that he can work with, but at least it hopefully will take a bit of time until he can get really threatening. And he builds another religion and takes the breakthrough and the efficient upgrade, and he will now be at 11 science, so if he indeed had no card to seed, then it is of course quite a bit unfortunate, because if there are indeed Dark Ages now, then he will lose now quite a bit more science. I this turn will develop the cannons, with that I will prepare myself even a bit better for the Dark Ages, and also again all of the cards that I have in hand I didn't really like to see that much, so I skip my politics phase, I increase my population with the ocean liner service, I go for building 1 cannon going up to 10 strength, being the strongest again, starting to invest into some cannons so that I at some point can transition into the fortifications maybe. And then, now that I have already a bit of a culture lead and have the biggest culture reduction, I thought maybe it's just best that I play it relatively safe, so I grabbed a military build-up for 3 resources, for 3 civil actions, that has the potential to give me 10 resources, which is quite a bit. And then I thought about something like upgrading the religion to drama to give me even more culture reduction, which definitely could be quite nice. I thought about taking the organized religion, because it could at least be nice to have it as a backup, to not potentially get into any trouble with my happy faces. But it just felt a bit bad to go for the organized religion, especially then I have to use my last civil action somehow. I mean, I could maybe just upgrade his farm, so that's not a big trouble then. But if I take the organized religion, I maybe don't really want to upgrade this religion. I mean, it's also not too bad. I could then just rebuild a religion. But I just thought with two pro spots being in there, with Marlene and with Treplin, I am willing to skip this organized religion. If I build another drama, then my happy face will be somewhat fine for now. And instead of taking the organized religion, I just took the patriotism. Copying the tactic, building some units will require some military actions. I don't have that much science, so maybe it's not that easy for me to implement a technology that gives me more military actions, like a government form or military theory. And with that, a military action could just be quite useful, also to threaten maybe more strength, and also the resources. With that, I have military build-up and patriotism in hand, so it's really not that easy for my opponents to maybe build up enough strength to go for a war against me, and if they do it, then I have hopefully some answers to that now with having those two cards in hand. That sadly means that I don't get a fourth drama going this turn, but I have already some fine culture production, and I just wanted to have those two cards in hand. And then I draw the Impact of Wonders, which could be a seedable impact. It's a bit better against Mata Beshir, and a little bit worse against Cengizib. Mata Beshir will seed now. He wants to get the Dark Ages out of the way before he gets more production again, and there are also indeed the Dark Ages in the deck. Cengizib loses now even the most, so that was indeed unfortunate that he couldn't seed, and I will now lose the least. But I also have the smallest production, so it still hurts me a bit. Mata Beshir will go for the Manhattan Project. I think that definitely makes sense. He has the engineering genius, so we can get that going quite cheaply. And it could be nice either to defend himself in case he doesn't get the military technologies quickly, or if he gets those quickly, and maybe also some war cards, it could also maybe make him even more threatening. And regardless of which of those things maybe happens, he also has quite some fine science production, so he also can get a decent amount of culture out of it. He then takes the urban growth, takes the movies, and with that maybe prepares to go for a bit of culture production. If he doesn't take a movie now, one movie and another multimedia will be discarded, so it could remove some options from him, and movies could turn out to be quite useful. Also, as you can see, Marlene Dietrich is actually coming down the road, so I was very interested to see now if Cengizib maybe will take her, or if I will be able to take her at my next turn. Cengizib offers the international tourism to me, which I was very happy about. We both have two wonders. Cengizib, of course, gets one more production, but I still very happily accepted this pact. It's still quite early in H3. So we both gain additional culture production from that. Cengizib builds an additional lab, going up to 7 culture science production, but he will even get more, because he will do that to be able to use the efficient upgrade that allows him to make, first of all, space in his hand without developing a technology, and that allows him to go for Einstein without having developed a technology. He can replace James Watt, who has done a nice job. Einstein is giving him some value immediately, so I think that makes some sense. It also means that I will be able to get Marlene Dietrich, but Marlene at the moment wouldn't do a lot for Cengizib. So I think for himself it makes a lot of sense to go for Einstein, and I have at the moment Bach anyway, so at some point Marlene Dietrich will be very useful for me, but for now Bach is also fine. And now, so Cengizib will go for Einstein, will start building some cannons, and has now definitely a decent economy, especially if he at some point maybe gets even more civil actions going. This turn I was then indeed willing to seed. I could have just started with seeding the Impact of Wonders, but now that I will be able to get Marlene, I thought the immigration has maybe the potential to do a bit of damage to my opponents at some point. Mata Beshir has of course the team sports, but who knows, maybe wants to go for movies, maybe will at some point end up with having an unhappy worker, and Cengizib has the St. Peter's Basilica, but maybe doesn't want to commit to religion. So we can of course build one, but maybe doesn't find the time to do it. So I thought maybe there's the chance that it could do some damage with Marlene Dietrich. Hopefully there is not really any big danger that it will be annoying for myself. So I started seeding that instead of the Impact of Wonders. And as the historic territory revealed, I was willing to bid all of my units beside the one cannon and my card. If I win it, it is somewhat costly, but I could maybe make it easier to make a transition into the cannons. But at the end, I am not able to win it, and Matabishir wins it for a rifleman. I will use the ocean liner service. I definitely want to have Marlene Dietrich. That's just very nice, knowing that I don't have to invest into any happy face solution, because she is my happy face solution. And then I also definitely want to have the first copy of Air Forces. I have a culture lead, and my culture lead will at this point maybe get bigger every turn. So one answer to that for my opponents could be military, so I should try my best to make sure that I can defend myself, and having the Air Force is definitely a part of that. So I want to have that. And now at the moment I have no free hand space, and so I can't take any more cards unless I elect Marlene, but for now I don't want to do that. Instead I build another drama, going up to 18 culture reduction. I was hoping that I still have enough population to put into the military. For now my opponents are still not that threatening. And then with my last civil action I will now start upgrading one farm. Could also play the revolutionary idea to make space in my hand, but at the next turn I might have to do this anyway, so both leaves me similarly flexible. I mean, in case there's something really important to take, I could maybe take famine, or maybe there is another way from the events to fix my food, even though I know I have knowledge about the prosperity. But still, it could be nice to have done this now. Maybe that will allow me to be more flexible at the future turn when I will be at the next area of my yellow bank. So, you know, just getting another drama going and an upgrade to irrigation, I think, should be quite nice. I could have also just upgraded the religion to drama, using Bach and keeping a free population for now. But there could be civil unrest. I would have an unhappy worker then, and just gives me more culture. In case there is an H3 government on the road next turn, having another urban building also will mean that I can get an H3 government form for even cheaper, and with that, I think the drama building one directly is maybe the better choice here. I will draw some impacts, both of them I probably don't want to see it, even though impact of progress at the moment is still quite fine, but my opponents maybe have the better chance to do something with it. I mean, if I still get something like military theory on H3 government, it might be possible to do something nice with it. The impact of technology very likely will just be very bad for me, so probably no impacts that I will see, but impacts where it is at least nice to have knowledge about that those are not in the deck. Matabishir seats and opens the strategic territory. Jengisip is able to win it and wins it for a cannon, so at least he has to doesn't get it for just a warrior. Could have even maybe sent three warriors away, but it would be somewhat costly, and he gets a lot of draws now with the strategic territory, so if he draws something like positional army, then could have been then quite annoying to send all of those warriors away, so he just sends the cannons away and gets now a lot of draws. Matabishir will go for computers, gets more science production going. That will also be nice together with the Manhattan Project. It's now even at 17 science production, takes the rockets, has now another military technology available, plays the wave, builds one, maybe has even drawn an H3 tactic for that, which could be likely because he doesn't take the tanks, and I think if he would have no tactic drawn, then maybe it could be worthwhile to take the knights, if he maybe draws from a modern army, it could be quite bad not having taken the tanks, not the knights, and so it could be quite likely that he has either entrenchments or positional army available, which means I have to be a bit careful. He doesn't have the most resources available, but if he gets some more yellow cards, then with the Manhattan Project and a potentially strong tactic, he maybe could potentially be a bit dangerous. Genghis succeeds and Iconoclasm is revealed, removing Bach, but at least I have Marlene available, so that is not too bad. I still lose the civil action and have to elect Marlene now, but it could have been a lot worse when I would have lost Bach without having a replacement in hand already. Jengisip will disband a warrior to rebuild one cannon, is now at 13 strength and the strongest, will take some reserves, get some resources going, and also the democracy. Going for the democracy, it could potentially mean that he maybe doesn't want to go for for a big military push or something, then maybe he could have gone for potentially something different, but he still has a lot of science, has a lot of stuff, takes those reserves, so he could also still go for military push, but he also has the democracy available, which might give him quite a nice boost. There's a Red Cross in there with having more civil actions, it makes it a lot easier for him to maybe take those, and also maybe it could be seen as a denial, removing that from me, as it could potentially give me an even bigger culture boost. Could also be a bit risky to invest my science into it, but maybe I would do it. At my turn, I am the weakest, but I also thought my opponents didn't put that much effort to get stronger. I mean, I am the weakest, so they did maybe put a little bit of effort into it now, but I just thought I want to use my chance to see it. It's an impact that will maybe be a bit better for me than for Mata Peshur. And I get the culture for seeding, so I just wanted to seed now. Then I also have the knowledge about what this H2 event is. And it is the inhabited territory. I again were willing to bid all of my units besides the cannons, but Mata Peshur is able to win it, and for Rifleman. This turn I will use the ocean liner service, and then. I have to be a bit careful here, because Mata Peshur has indicated that maybe he has something like entrenchments or positional army available. He has the Manhattan Project, so he could get potentially still a bit dangerous, even though he doesn't have the most resource, but he has some, so he could potentially set maybe something up, and I have to be a bit careful about it, so I have to prepare myself for the military. But I also thought this internet could be nice to have, because the other wonders will probably not really do anything for me, and while I have a nice culture lead, with the strong economy, there is definitely a chance that the impacts will be in favor of my opponents. They may catch up some points with that, and I thought having a wonder available that I can finish for a lot of points could still be quite worthwhile for me, so my goal was basically to set myself up nicely for the military, but if possible also get the internet. I thought about the military theory, because it could maybe also be nice to remove this from Mata Peshur. There is a second copy, but if he gets this later, it might also already be something. If I leave it to him, he has an easy way to get more military actions, maybe making war preparations potentially a lot easier for him. But with having the Acropolis, I, at the end, after electing Marlene Dietrich, which I definitely want to do, I made a decision to go for the fundamentalism, because that will help me with the military. It will of course drop my science production, but it also only costs me 9 science, so at the moment it's actually cheaper than the military theory, and then of course I will do some science production, so long term it will be a bit more costly, but not that much. And the fundamentalism has also the advantage that I have an H3 government form going then, and together with the Acropolis I can even build another drama if I want to. If I go for the military theory, I leave myself open for the second copy of Democracy, but if my opponents try something with the military, I might not have the chance to develop the democracy anyway, or it would at least be somewhat greedy, so I thought with the fundamentalism I do 2 things at once. I have a way to fix my military, or to help me with my military, but I also have a way to get another drama going and get even more cultural reduction going. So I take that fundamentalism, I can just develop it thanks to having built the drama instead of upgraded the religion at a turn before, and then with my last civil actions I will take the internet. I felt a little bit bad about not taking the military theory, also not taking the revolutionary idea, so grabbing the internet is somewhat greedy. Maybe taking military theory and revolutionary idea would make me a bit safer in regards of the military. Now Mata Peshur will be able to get the military theory, I don't have the revolutionary idea available, which would allow me to go for air forces in 2 turns, so it is somewhat greedy. But I also have a lot of resource saved up, I have a lot of military actions also with the patriotism, and with that and with being able to copy the fortifications, which I will actually do now, I have already 1 copy now, thanks to Marlene Dietrich. I was hoping that I still am in a position where I can maybe threaten enough strength, and there are also still 2 other revolutionary ideas left in the deck, so there are also some chances that I maybe could still hope to get a revolutionary idea the next turn. Maybe it's too greedy, maybe I should rather play it safe, but then on the other hand, I also thought that my culture lead is big, but it's definitely not impossible for my opponents to overtake me peacefully, and so I also wanted to have this internet, I have the chance to build another drama, then I think it's already a little bit above 20 for me, And in two turns, I have enough science, for example, to go for computers. If there's the second copy, maybe I somehow get into multimedia. So there are ways how I can make it even bigger in case the game stays peaceful. Then I will draw some cards, the hybrid war, another tactic, and a peace treaty. Mata Bashir will seed. The impact was seeded by him, and it's also a nice one for him. The impact of science will give him plus 14 against me, and of course, you can see that with those impacts, my opponents start already catching up a bit now. Mata Bashir will go for Mandela, is willing to pay the additional price for him, doesn't go for Chaplin movies. Maybe he doesn't really have the resource to invest into movies that nicely, and Mandela does give him some easy culture production. And he has now a lot of civil actions, actually, because he will also go for the civil service. Builds the rifleman, builds the rocket, and he has indeed the entrenchments tactic going up to 25 strength, making sure that he is the strongest and doesn't have the most resource still, but has the military theory, can finish the Manhattan Project, so I at least have to be a bit careful at the next turn. Genghis goes for the democracy, gets some more culture reduction, and he will just go for the Red Cross. He can't finish it this turn, but he sees that I don't have enough food to build a step, so he will get 4 steps at the next turn if he wants to, and then it's definitely quite a fine wonder for him. And he also then starts building some cannons, is now 31 strength, and with that, somewhat threatening either to play an aggression potentially, which is a bit of a concern for me. I only have an H2 defense card in hand, and if he gets Air Force, could even go up to 51 with the war, with having 5 military actions, so he is also putting a bit of pressure on me and not allowing me to just do a lot of peaceful stuff. This turn was a bit of a puzzle. First of all, I seeded the prosperity. I know that there's the immigration on top, and I just wanted to get the 2 culture for seeding. I don't have anything better to do with my politics phase. I still wanted to have the resource from the international trade agreement, so I seed the prosperity into the deck, and the immigration is revealed. No one loses any population to that. This turn was a little bit of a puzzle. I have multiple goals that I want to fulfill. First of all, there are air forces in the row. Maybe Mata Bashir will just take those away. But there is a chance maybe he will let them through to Cengizip. Maybe if he feels safe and maybe wants to give Cengizip the chance to go for war against me if I am not careful. So there I have to at least count towards one of my opponents going up to 51 strength, but it should be the maximum. Unless Mata Bashir offers a military alliance pact before that. So I have to prepare myself for strength in order to defend against a war. Ideally, I also want to be able to defend against an aggression, even though maybe that could be something I could miss out on, because I would not need that many defense cards, and maybe Genghis wouldn't try an aggression, but it would be somewhat nice to be able to defend against an aggression. And then I also wanted to set myself up to finish my last turn nicely. The next turn could be my last. Mata Bashir has a lot of civil actions. Genghis might finish the Red Cross, so he maybe won't take that many cards. So it's definitely not guaranteed that the age will end, but it's definitely possible. And so I also wanted to set myself up nicely for my last turn. And for that, I wanted to be able to go for multimedias to make my internet potentially even bigger. And there are multiple ways how I can set myself up for the multimedia. For example, I can just build a third alchemy now, which also will be somewhat fine for the internet, and then with playing the revolutionary idea, I would have enough science to go for the multimedia at the next turn. Or I can just take multimedia and revolutionary idea. And at the end, I came to the conclusion that it is important. First of all, I also really want to get a fifth drama going. And then I came to the conclusion that it is important to set myself up with enough science to go for Air Force at the next turn. Because with not being able to go for Air Forces, I thought that, I don't remember the calculations precisely, but I think I could somewhat defend myself, but I would have to destroy a lot and I can't finish the internet. And then, if maybe Mata Bashir lets the Air Force through to Cengizip, it could definitely be an idea for him to maybe declare war against me and prevent me from finishing the internet. So I have to be careful, and with not being able to develop the Air Forces, I would be a bit in danger, because I thought about different turns. Now I have a full hand, I can just play this copy of Revolutionary Idea, but I also thought about playing the Patriotism, then with building a cannon I just spent this one resource. I can even then take Urban Growth or Engineering Genius. Depending on whether I need a civil action or not, I could maybe think about Engineering Genius as a denial, but I come to the conclusion that I need the civil action if I want to take a resource card to allow me to build more stuff with the internet at the next turn. And so I considered something like this, but I, as said, came to the conclusion that I need the air forces, and for that I will play the revolutionary idea, and then I will also play the patriotism, and with that I will build one cannon to get out of corruption. I won't take any of those cards, but with like this getting out of corruption without spending a lot of resources, I have enough resources to develop the multimedia at the next turn, finish the internet, build a multimedia, of course in the other order, and then also I have enough resources to go for this farm upgrade. And with the orb growth, I could maybe do a little bit more, but I also would have to delete some stuff. Could be fine, I could maybe build another religion, and it also would make my internet a little bit better. But I would have to delete something. If there's impact of harmony, it could be bad. Also impact of competition I can make bigger if I just play the military build-up and move some workers into cannons from warriors. So I thought that I might not want to do this anyway, and then I don't need any of those yellow cards. And I had to be a bit careful, because I might, if I plan too much for the next turn, I might not have the civil actions to do it. But doing all of this, I still had one issue to solve, and that is that like this, I still am not completely safe from an aggression. I said maybe I could be fine with it, but there is actually a solution to that problem, and that is with playing the modern army tactic. With having that outdated, I cannot defend against an aggression, unless Mortarboschur and somehow the age before Genghis' turn, but that should be very, very unlikely. So I can defend. Yeah, and with that I thought it should be a nice turn, but what I had to check is, of course, if I can actually defend against the wall now if I reveal the tactic, because copying back the fortifications tactic, I have used the patriotism now, so I have only 5 military actions, would be a bit tricky and would not be enough, but the modern army tactic will also be enough to defend against the wall. It would be somewhat costly. I would need to go for air forces, and then I can go for 2 air forces, and go for another knight and warrior, and get then 2 modern outdated modern army tactics with air forces. That is more enough than to defend against a potential war. So even if Genghis wants to go for a war to prevent me from finishing the internet, he won't do it, especially not because I can even go for this defense with the military build-up and finish the internet. Of course not with the multimedia, but I could finish the internet and defend against the war, so I should be quite safe now. I'm also safe from an aggression, and if the age should end and the game finishes, I can build a multimedia and finish the internet for, I think, 26 points. So I thought that should be a nice turn, a nice way to play out this turn. I draw another war, impact of colonies. Mortarboschur has 2, I and Genghis have 1, so it could potentially maybe be seeded for the culture, and the impact of balance is bad for me, but at least I also have the knowledge that it isn't in the deck, because especially for Genghis it is looking like a quite a strong impact at the moment. Mortarboschur seeds, and the impact of culture is revealed, which was actually quite a surprise for me. The impact that I seeded was the impact of wonders in this deck, so that probably was seeded by Genghis. Maybe to gain 7 culture against Mortarboschur. Maybe he was in a position where he really needed to seed and didn't have anything better in hand. Maybe he, at the point when he seeded it, had some hopes to overtake me in culture production. And whatever happened, I definitely was happy that there's actually a nice impact in there, which was something that I really didn't really expect, or at least not the impact of culture. There are some other impacts that are somewhat nice for me, but no, definitely a nice surprise for me. Mortarboschur takes the Engineering Genius, uses the other Engineering Genius to build the first step, builds also a stage of the Red Cross from Genghis, builds a warrior, takes the engineering and develops it, takes the reserves, develops the military theory, and now he takes the efficient upgrade, will upgrade the warrior now, so that was just a little fun move to build this warrior earlier on. Now he upgrades it anyway, and then he at the end plays the reserves resources. Which is interesting, because he, not playing the reserves, but he interestingly didn't take that many cards, and he left the air forces to Genghis, maybe allowing him the possibility to potentially maybe set up something with some strength, and also allowing him to maybe that the age won't end, so Maybe he came to the conclusion that this might be beneficial for him at the end, that it maybe opens up some chances for him. And Cengizib will indeed take advantage of that. He will finish the Red Cross, he will take the Air Forces, he will develop the Cavalryman, and then he disbands those two warriors, builds those two Cavalrymen, and reveals the mechanized army tactic is now at 45 strength, and that the next turn he has just enough military actions to declare war and go for two air forces, has just enough resources with the reserves, and also will, after taking the oil, develop the satellites this turn, and with going for two air forces at the next turn he can go up to 78 strength. So now things start to get a bit dangerous, and I have to be very careful with my turn and have to prepare for that. And and now there will be one card left in the deck, so the age won't end. At my turn, I made a decision, first of all, to indeed cede the impact of colonies. It's the same for me as for Cengizib. It's plus 3 for Matabeshur, but I will get 3 culture for ceding, and with that it will basically give me plus 3 against Cengizib compared to not ceding. And while there is the danger that there is maybe an impact revealed that they will improve during the turn, there's also the chance that an impact is revealed that maybe would be improved during one turn of my opponent's. And so I thought at the end it should be fine to seed it just for the 3 culture against Cengizib. The impact of Harmony is revealed, which is another fine impact for me. I have 20, Matabeshur 16, and Cengizib has 20, so far I'm quite happy about the impacts. The impact of science, of course, was not that great, but there are some impacts where I'm weak in, so I have to expect some weak impacts. And no, this turn again was a bit of a puzzle. And it was especially a bit of a puzzle because I at the beginning was a bit too focused in one direction, which was not the best direction. Because I need to do my best to be set up for this war. If there's also a way to set myself up to not be in danger of an aggression, that would be a nice benefit on top. And it would be nice to maybe not invest too many resources now into the military, so that I can potentially still finish quite a big internet. It's maybe not that important. The most important thing is that I am safe from wars and aggressions, or especially from a war, but it would be a nice thing on top. And first I thought that I want to go for tanks, and then prepare myself to copy the mechanized army tactic at the next turn. I can go for tanks this turn, and with playing the revolution already, I can still go for air forces, and then at the next turn I could set myself up to go for two mechanized armies with air forces, even a little bit more, and then I could win a war if Cengizib declares one against me. But it is a bit tricky to set myself up for this nicely, because I need to copy the tactic at the next turn, then I still need some military actions to build the units, so I kinda need this patriotism, and having to take this patriotism will make me... take some other options away from me. For example, I won't have the civil action to play the military build-up, meaning in order to start investing into some units this turn, which I need to do, I need to spend a lot of resource, which is maybe not that ideal. And also, because I have to copy the tactic at the next turn, I can win the war, but I also feared that there might be the danger that Cengizib could even go for losing war just to remove me from finishing the internet and going for multimedia. I was not certain if he would really do it, because Matabeshur actually might very likely not be able to set himself up to defend against the war. It will be close. So I thought there might be the chance Cengizib could try a war against me if the difference is not that big, if I can't get that much stronger just to prevent me from finishing the internet. So I ideally wanted to go for a turn where I can even threaten quite a bit more strength than just winning the war by a little bit. And at the end I came to the conclusion that I was just too much focused on the mechanized army tactic, and that the better approach is actually to go for the entrenchments tactic that I can already copy this turn. And I have also at least two warriors instead of only one knight. I developed a modern infantry. I play the military build-up. Now that I can copy the tactic this turn, there's no need to take the patriotism, because I will have enough military actions at the next turn to threaten the amount of strength that I want to threaten. I can use the military build-up like this, being able to build some units without spending too many resources, leaving myself with a lot of resources for the internet still. So with that, just everything comes together. I build one cannon, I upgrade those two units, that gets me out of corruption, I can copy the tactic, and with doing that, with Marlene, I even can defend against an aggression, so this turn is just a perfect solution, and after I found this one, I very quickly came to the conclusion that this has to be the best, because it also comes perfectly together with being able to threaten a lot of strength. I have just enough science to go for Air Force at the next turn, and I have 29 resources, and I have potentially enough to threaten two Air Forces first of all to gain two more tactics. But then after building those, I have still 15 resources left, which is just enough to go for three more cannons. And thanks to Marlene, that would allow me to go for another tactic. And with that, I would be over 90 strength, and then the strength difference, I thought, is just too big to make Cengizip go for war to remove me the possibility for me to finish the internet, and with that I felt very safe. Of course I would have to destroy a lot, but I actually would be able to do it with playing revolutionary air forces, and then I can spend 5 civil actions to destroy a lot of stuff. Which is of course bad, but at least the impact of harmony is already out. I know that the impact of balance is not in there. And then I would just win the war back quite a bit. And so I thought that with this play, I very likely won't be the target of a war. I won't be the target of an aggression, at least for now. And I have still a lot of resources, enough resources to build a multimedia, finish the internet and go for an upgrade to my farms. And even a little bit more, so I can even do a bit of additional stuff. I will lose 4 culture to the famine, so that's one downside, but I think that I just couldn't fix this as well, and it's not too bad to lose those 4 culture. Mata Beshir seeds, the impact of wonders is revealed, that was seeded by me, it gives me +3 against Mata Beshir, but -3 against Cengizip. Mata Beshir will take the bro sports, that will help him defend himself. He also will get the patriotism, another efficient upgrade if he wants to. He will have a bit of trouble to set himself up to defend himself. He will take all of the resources that he can get, also all of the technologies that give him some strength, won't be able to get enough strength to defend against the war, at least with what he has available now. And with that, Cengizip is going for the war. He has to destroy quite a bit, yes, as you can see at the moment, an uprising needs some more units, so it won't be a cheap war, so maybe there could have been also a play without the war, but he comes to the conclusion that it should still be best. He has to destroy some stuff, but will remove some culture from Mata Beshir, will maybe force his play a little bit, and will go up to 78 strength, has to destroy some stuff, and then takes those two technologies. And now at my turn, this turn it's relatively simple. First of all, I will offer the peace treaty to Mata Beshir just for an additional 1 culture for both of us. And then I will go for the multimedia. I will even use the ocean liner service to build one. And with that I go a lot into famine, but the good news is I can finish the internet for 26 points. And then I have just enough resources with deleting this knight to build the farm and to go for an upgrade to not lose any culture. And with that, that is a very nice last turn, scoring also 24 culture production, and I was hoping that I will be able to keep my lead. Mata Beshir offers me the military alliance, and with that I counted of course how nicely he can defend, and he would be able to go without the pact to go for 3 less strength, so with the pact he can actually tie with Cengizip. And with Mata Beshir being a bit behind in culture, with Cengizip having finished the Red Cross, I thought that Cengizip is the bigger contender, and with that I was definitely willing to accept this military alliance. Mata Beshir goes for the democracy, goes for another team sports, with that he has 2 arenas, can use both of the efficient upgrades to upgrade those arenas, will then play the reserves, finishes the Manhattan Project, will play the patriotism, is just enough resource, and all left to go for 1 rocket, and that gives him another tactic, and with that he is at 78 strength. That means that Cengizip only ties in the war now, and he will play an armed intervention against me, goes for the computers with Einstein, builds a religion, builds another religion, just for a bit more culture reduction, ends his turn, and then we take a look at the culture before the final impacts. We can see that there are quite some gaps between the players, not big enough that there is no chance at all that there will be some changes in the final impacts, but it is not unlikely that there will be no changes. And the first impact brings the players a little bit more together, the impact of strength, giving Mata Beshir the most culture. Then there is the impact of agriculture, also giving both of my opponents a little bit of additional culture, but I still have quite a decent lead. Then there's the impact of population. That impact is even quite nice for me with having had the ocean liner service. I gained plus 4 against both of my opponents. And the last impact was seeded by me, the impact of colonies, giving me plus 3 and plus 6 to Mata Beshir. And with that, at the end, I am able to win this game. Cengizip is at the second position and Mata Beshir at the third position. And Cengizip at the end actually told in the chat that he misplayed his last turn a little bit because he had knowledge about the impact of strength and just forgot to build a warrior instead of building the religion. But even if he would have gotten 7 more culture out of this, it still wouldn't have changed anything for the standings. So, the impact of strength was actually seeded by him. It could have been Mata Beshir didn't seed at his last turn. Otherwise, maybe it could have been a sneaky seed from him also, but Cengizip had knowledge about this, but just forgot to build a warrior. And, a game where I actually go for a bunch of culture reduction. Normally I try to go for just some very big economy often in 3 and 4 player games. But I had the Acropolis and I had the opportunity to go for Bach. And at the end I just thought it might leave me in the best position. Then it just worked out relatively nicely. It was also nice that I got Marlene Dietrich early on, knowing that I don't need to invest anything more into a Happy Face illusion, and also it was quite nice to have her in hand when the Iconoclasm was revealed. And then also it was good that both of my opponents didn't have a nice way to build up some military quickly. That left me with being able to have some time to prepare myself. Cengizip then set himself up to go for war with 78 strength. But I was able to set myself up with being able to get the last 2 copies of the revolutionary ideas with having Marlene Dietrich. I was even able to threaten more than 90 strength. And with that, I couldn't be attacked. And with having the internet, I then managed to keep my culture lead and win this game at the end. A bit of an unusual game for me. Having 5 dramas is of course very nice. A little smiley face. And game with a bit of culture reduction. The ocean liner service also did some nice work, so I think if I wouldn't have gotten this, maybe would have gone for selective breeding instead. Maybe it could have been also fine at the end, but even though the ocean liner service was late and somewhat costly, I still think it did a very nice job for me. And of course the Acropolis is probably the star of the civilization, with allowing me to going for all of those cheap dramas, even though I otherwise wouldn't have had the urban building for it, the urban building limit. Alright, and with this game having finished, we can also take a look at the standings. And no other game has finished apart from this one compared to the standings at the beginning, or actually there have now been some other games finished, but I will show the standings when only this game was finished, so that you don't have any potential spoilers for DJ Parson videos. So we will take a look at the standings now, and And with this game finished and with me being able to win it, I am now at 9 games finished and 34 points. And of course, I am very happy about the current position in the standings. My 2 and 3 player game performance has been quite nice so far in the finals. The 4 player games, like in the stages before, have been not as great, but overall, of course, I'm very happy about how the finals went so far for me. So I have quite a big lead at the moment, but Himmelstosh has only 7 games finished. If he, for example, manages to win his next 2, he is definitely still not that far away. So I definitely shouldn't start feeling safe and should still try my best to score as many points as possible. And the other players are a bit more away, but with a lot of games to come, it's also still not completely impossible for them to overtake me. For Mata Beshir, it's getting very close now. He has already 11 games finished, but if he should win all of the remaining games, and if I lose all of the remaining games, he could still overtake me. So it's not... it's still potentially a chance, but of course, that is maybe not that likely, but he is not out of the running. And has also still chances, and also Swin, I think if he should win all of his remaining 7 games, then he also has enough points to still overtake me. So I'll have still chances. Himmelstorch has probably the best chances to overtake me. But of course, at the moment, I'm quite happy about the lead that I have in the standings and about how the games went so far for me. Alright, and I hope it was an interesting game for you. When this video will be uploaded, I will be not at home for 2 days, and so don't be surprised or don't wonder when I won't be able to answer your comments immediately. Probably you will have to wait a little bit. Of course, I'm still happy about every comment, and also in the next days I will be quite a bit busy, so I can't say yet when the next video will be coming. For now, when I record this, there has not been any other game from me finished anyway, but there might be some finished relatively soon, and I have to see how quickly I will be able to record a video. Maybe I will find the time for it, but it could also potentially be that it will take a little bit longer than usual, so just that you have a knowledge about this. Alright, then thanks for watching, and then see you in the next video.